Sheila Walsh is more than friend. She's like a mischievous younger sister who always gave me trouble, but she's here. She's family. And today she's back for a visit with us. Before we catch up with Sheila, let's take a quick look at what's been going on in her life.
I can do it!
Sheila Walsh was co-host of the 700 Club for 5 years.
Junk food is never good for kids.
The hills are alive with the sound of music.
Since she left the show in 1992, Sheila's kept busy. She's a Grammy-nominated vocalist, best-selling author, and a featured speaker for Women of Faith conferences.
Our real lives will begin.
In her new book, Get Off Your Knees and Pray, Sheila shares where she gets her source of strength and encouragement.
Well, please welcome back to the 700 Club a dear, dear friend, Sheila Walsh.
Hey, Pat. It's lovely to see you.
It's so good to see you.
Can I introduce you to a little friend of mine?
Yeah, what's that?
This is Flat Stanley. Have you ever heard of Flat Stanley?
No.
Well, any mother of a first grader knows Flat Stanley. And the kids read the book, and then they do a cutout of Flat Stanley, and Flat Stanley is sent on a trip. So my little friend Wilson sent Flat Stanley to the 700 Club with me, so hey, Wilson!
Isn't that sweet? So we've got Flat Stanley?
We've got Flat Stanley. We've got it all here, Pat, as you know.
How long will Flat stay? Is he just passing through?
Flat's on his way home.
Okay. I didn't know. Well, listen, when you were here, you were doing the show and you were having concerts all over the place and you were ragged out. Now, to stand, you've got 30 weekends on the road. How do you do it?
Well, you know, I discovered something that I'm sure you learned a long time ago, that if what we're doing comes from out there, we're going to run out of steam. But if what we're doing comes from deep inside, from an absolute assurance that God has called us to do it, and every morning I get up and this is my morning prayer every day. I'll go outside and I'll say, good morning, Father. Wherever you're going today, that's where I'm going. It might not be the path I would have chosen. I might not even understand it. But if it's where you're going, it's where I'm going. Amen. And then I don't have to worry about it.
That's beautiful. Well, you've got that cute little boy you brought here on who's just a little baby, and now he's 11-year-old, and they're very active at the age of 11.
Yeah.
What's the most challenging part of raising him? I've had four of them, so I know a few things.
I just think he's a great kid, Christian. He's almost 12, and he's a big football player.
Oh, is he?
Oh, loves it, and also a great soccer player and basketball player.
Yeah.
But I love his heart. We had a parent-teacher conference last week, and one of the things his teacher said to me was, the thing I love about Christian is he has a gentle leadership. You know, he draws people to him from his heart. And I love that, because, I mean, he's all boy, and if you think I was mischievous, just wait till you meet my son. Yeah.
He's worse than you?
Oh, way worse, way worse. In a totally godly way.
A godly worse.
Yeah, it's a good godly worse.
Well, Sheila, you've got a book, it's a very intriguing cover. Get Off Your Knees and Pray. What are you talking about?
Pat, 2 years, 2005 and 2006, were two of the darkest years of my life. You know, you go through seasons where you think the enemy is just attacking on every level. And I thought, Lord, how am I going to make it through this? And it was so clear, you know, if you just get down on your knees for 10 minutes every morning and get down on your knees for 20 minutes at night, you're not going to make it. Uh-huh. You need to live in my presence 24/7. You need to walk with me all the time and be in constant communion. Mm. And so that's why I call it Get Off Your Knees and Pray, because to me, praying, I think it was Bill Bright who said, prayer is not preparation for the battle. Prayer is the battle.
Yeah.
So that, and I think in these days that we're living, so much talk about change, but what you do here at 700 Club has changed lives.
That's it.
And that's what will last forever. And that's what it's about. If you will get up every day, put your hand on your Father's hand and walk through that day with him, then you will have a peace no matter what's going on.
Well, that's what the First Psalm says, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, and blessed are those people because you're rooted and grounded, and you know where your strength's coming from.
You don't sit in the way of sinners, but you get up and your delight's in the law of the Lord. But I understand Christian, going back to some of the trials you've had, he was diagnosed with leukemia.
Well, it was one of those interesting trials where, for a time, we didn't know exactly what was wrong. I knew he was sick, and the doctor ran blood tests. And we had to wait for one particular test where the doctor said, yeah, it may well be leukemia. And I stayed up all that night. Yeah. I mean, Christian said to his dad and I, can I sleep in your bed tonight? And I'm like, yeah, you want a pony? I mean, it was just, you know, you get to that desperate place. But I just walked all night long and I said, Lord, give it to me. Mm. Give it to me, please. I would take it in a heartbeat over my son.
Yeah.
And in the morning, What I discovered was Dag Hammarskjöld, who used to be Secretary of the United Nations, wrote a wonderful book called Markings. And in it, toward the end of his spiritual life, of his life before he died, he put, "For everything that has been, thank you. And for everything that will be, yes." And I thought, that's what I prayed by the end of that night. Yes. Christian didn't have leukemia. He ended up to be very anemic. And I told the story from stage at Women of Faith, one of our events, and a woman said to me, "I got the other call. I got the call that my daughter did have leukemia." And she said, "But what you need to know is whether you get the answer you pray for or the answer you dread, God is enough. He will be there."
Praise God. That's beautiful. Where do you get this book, How to Get Off Your Knees and Pray?
Well, you can either get it in any good Christian bookstore, or you can go to my website, SheilaWalsh.com, or, or womenoffaith.com, or CBN.com, where I do much of my Christmas shopping.
Of course. What a wonderful book. Sheila Walsh, a dear, dear friend. So you're out on the road, I mean, 30 weekends?
You know, it's amazing, Pat. And you know what I think is interesting? We've spoken to more than 4 million women at Women of Faith events, but we're seeing more salvations. 2 weekends ago, we saw 3,000 women make first-time commitments to Christ.
Stop it. Are you serious?
Oh, absolutely. The numbers of people coming to the Lord for the first time are doubling because people are desperate.
Yeah.
They know that what we're looking for, no matter who wins the presidency, what we're looking for is not going to come from the Oval Office.
Sure.
What we're looking for is going to come from the throne of grace. And people are hungry. And yeah, God's really, it's amazing.
Well, are these young women, old women, middle-aged women?
Absolutely across the board, from 18 to 80, from Protestants, Catholics, every background or no background at all. We've had, we had a couple of women who came in a few weeks ago who were actually prostitutes, and somebody just gave them tickets on the street. So yeah, God is doing something huge through these things.
Well, I'm so proud of you. It's
great
to see you.
I love you.
Well, I love you too. You know that. Whether it was a naughty sister or my daughter.
I thought it was a naughty daughter.
Naughty daughter.
Yeah.
Daughter's more like
Thank you.
All right. Well, daughter, please come back soon.
Thank you. God bless you.
Sheila Walsh. Book, Get Off Your Knees and Pray.